2, air number 2, tape 7965, air 926.
Is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Moon River, wider than the night. I'm crossing you in style someday.
Show with Andy's guest, David McCallum. Cliff Arquette as Charlie Weaver. Special guest, Miss Judy Garland. Good time singer. Brought to you by Kraft. Kraft for good food and good food ideas. And now, here is the star of our show, Andy Williams.
Appear in the sky, dare any raindrop to plop in my eye on a wonderful day like today, on a wonderful evening like this. The moon is as big as a silver balloon, even the birdies are singing in tune on a wonderful evening like this. On an evening like this, I could kiss everybody. I'm so furthermore, I'd adore everybody. Come and dine, the pleasure's mine, and I will pay the bill. May I take this occasion to say that the whole human race should get down on its knees, so that we're grateful for moments like these on a wonderful day. On a wonderful day, on a wonderful day, like
today. Now tonight we invite you to fly. If you leave it to us, we may never come back. Fasten your seatbelt, sit back and relax. Say hello to a wonderful guy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David McCallum.
David, you look very relaxed for a man who spends the whole week hunting down the men in the black hats.
Well, when I leave the studio, I like to leave Ilya Kuryakin back in the wardrobe.
Yeah, I imagine after 6 o'clock, you're no longer the man from Uncle, huh?
No, I'm just playing David McCallum from the mortgaged house in the Hollywood Hills. Mm.
Are you sure that nothing dangerous ever happens to you in real life?
No, I lead a very normal life with my family.
Gee, that's, that's interesting, David. I'll see you later.
Yeah.
No.
This is truly a red letter day. We just stuck in a thumb and came up with a plum. Bring on the trumpets and roll out the drum. Here's that wonderful, 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 wonderful.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Judy Garland.
Furthermore, I adore everybody to rise and shine. The pleasure's mine, and I will pay the bill. May we take this occasion to say that the whole human race should go down on its knees. Show that we're grateful for evenings like these.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Judy Garland.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. The sun is shining, come on, get happy. Lord, it's weightless, take your hand. Away in the tide, it's all so peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles and just get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day.
Hallelujah.
Judy, that was just marvelous.
Well, thank you. David, what are you doing out here with the makeup table?
Well, if you'll excuse me here. There's something I'd like you to do for me, if you will.
I think you want me to wash up and get my money and get out of here.
Nobody has done clown or tramp numbers the way you have. And I've always thought that I might like to do one sometime, but I don't know how to put on that makeup or anything, and I thought maybe you could show me.
Oh, sure.
Would you please?
Sure, come on. Right. Makeup is very important. What's wrong, honey?
David, The Man from U.N.C.L.E. is really, really a great show. We watch it at our house all the time.
Thank you very much, Andy. It's always nice to hear that.
You know, you and Napoleon Solo get in some of the wildest, most dangerous situations. I mean, you jump from buildings into moving cars and swim through...
Shark-infested waters?
Then you walk through those...
Minefields,
yeah. It's a wonder you don't get hurt.
Well, we do have accidents on the show sometime. Last week, I had an accident. I lost a tooth.
In a fight scene?
No, I was eating a box of Cracker Jacks, and I bit into the prize.
Those tin whistles are murder. They really are. You know what fascinates me the most on your show is the wild equipment that you use to track down those...
Men in the black hats.
Yeah. I mean, bullets that go around corners, you know, and umbrellas that convert into flamethrowers, and binoculars that you can look right through buildings.
Well, they're not really as wild as you think, you know. I read in the paper last week of some scientists who'd invented a very powerful acid that could dissolve anything.
Really? That's amazing.
Mm. The only thing is that they can't find anything to keep it in.
Well, you know, David, I noticed one thing on your show. The thing that, the fact that you were able to conceal all your equipment and all that electrical device and things, you know, on your person, and they don't even bulge your suit.
Well, we have to be pretty ingenious, you know. Well, look at my shoe. You notice anything?
Well, you could use a shine.
Yeah, anything else?
No, it's perfectly...
All right, smile.
What do you mean, smile?
Just look at my shoe and smile.
Why?
Andy, please. Just look at my shoe, smile, and well, say cheese.
Crap.
I just took your picture.
You're kidding.
No, really, what?
Wonderful. I'm gonna have to buy some of that stock. Hey, you know, can I borrow that shoe from you sometime when I go to Disneyland?
Well, you better take the other shoe, too.
What would I want with the other shoe?
Pull the lace.
What would I want with the other shoe?
I just recorded your voice with it.
Yeah, I tell you, you're loaded with gadgets.
Yeah.
What does your belt do?
It keeps up my trousers.
I got one of those.
Hey, here's something you might be interested in. Look, you see this little green pill?
Yeah.
You know what it does?
Can I guess?
Yeah, please.
You drop it into a glass of water and it turns into a car.
No, that would be ridiculous. It's the red one that does that. No, you see, sometimes in my work it's necessary for me to disguise myself as another person.
Yeah.
Well, I don't just disguise my appearance, I also disguise my voice. I just take one of those little green pills, and it coats my voice box with a special chemical, which will pick up vocal impulses from anybody I want to tune into with my special uncle receiver.
That's fantastic. You mean you can talk like anybody?
Yeah, I can sing like anybody.
Can you sing like me?
Oh, you're too easy. Let's do a tough one.
Tough one, huh? You ready?
Yep.
Jack, would you give David an introduction, please?
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. The winds grow colder. Suddenly you're older. And all behind the man that got away.
Oh, come on, Andy. Let's finish it.
Exciting feeling, I can feel it stealing over me. From a kiss came a spark like a flash in the dark, thus spontaneous combustion. My heart's boom booming and my temperature is zooming, zooming like a human mercury. Oh, my thermostat is shaking, my thermometer is breaking from this feeling that's stealing over me. Want to spread my wings like a honeybee. Want to talk about love, want to talk about you, want to talk about me. Want to tell the world what I'm thinking of. I feel like coming on strong to sing my song of love. because it's so appealing, this exciting feeling called love. Came a spark in the dark, spontaneous combustion. This feeling that's stealing over me. Want to spread my wings like a honeybee. Want to talk about love, want to talk about you, want to talk about me. Want to tell the world what I'm thinking of. I feel like coming on strong and singing my song of love. Because it's so appealing, this exciting feeling called love.
Thank you very much. You know, I'm really looking forward to this next part of our show, because I'll be talking to a man whom I've admired for many years.
Yeah, wonderful fellow. Love that fellow.
I'm sure you've seen him many times on the Jack Parr Show.
Yeah, 20 years with Merton Mark. Never missed a cue.
He's one of America's most beloved humorists. Ladies and gentlemen, Cliff Arquette is Charlie Weaver.
Hey, George, it's nice to see you.
Well, it's nice to see you, too.
I had a terrible time getting here, you know.
What happened?
Well, I was driving in the freeway, you know, in my Model T. I was doing 87 miles an hour.
No, wait a minute. I've seen that car. You weren't going 87 miles an hour in that Model T.
I wasn't.
No, you're...
Well, I was coming right down the middle of the freeway there, doing 72 miles an hour.
Wait a minute. 72 miles an hour is fast for any car. Your Model T can't go... you couldn't possibly go 72 miles an hour.
64?
I've seen your car. Your car, you're lucky if you're going 20.
32?
20 at the most.
Well, me and my mama was pushing my car down the street. And I want to tell you, then I turned right off the freeway to come over here, you know. Got into more trouble.
You did?
I was coming along there, and a fella stepped off the curb, and I run right over him before I could stop, you know. And I turned back, and I hollered, "Hey, you look out." He raised up his head, and he says, "What's the matter? You coming back?" I did. I backed up over him. Mark, you know, I hate smart. Say, I got a letter from Mama.
I know you did.
How'd you know that?
Well, I mean, you always have.
Yeah,
one.
That's why you got your own show, I guess.
She writes you every day, doesn't she?
Oh, yes, every day.
Yeah.
She said, "Your dear surfboard."
She called you surfboard?
Yeah, she used to call me that when I was little. She had to paddle me so much. "Things are fine in Mount Ida," she goes on.
I bet they are.
Yeah, she goes on and on. You remember Grandma Ogg?
Yeah.
Little
yeah.
bitty woman.
Yeah,
you know,
I remember her.
Beautiful gray hair way down her back. None on her head, but all that hair. Grandma Ogg had to let her maid go.
Oh, that's a shame.
Because Grandpa wouldn't. Elsie Crack. Remember Elsie?
Yes,
you lovely right. girl. Elsie Crack dropped in on us yesterday. "Mercy, I can't understand why she isn't a movie star. She sings like Doris Day, dances like Ann Miller, and can act like Susan Hayward." Only trouble is, she looks like Lassie. She told us that she and Ludlow Bean had broken their engagement. Oh, that's sad, isn't it?
It is.
Seems like the other night they had an argument and Elsie slapped Ludlow in the face.
Oh, that's terrible.
He was chewing tobacco at the time. So they broke up their engagement. Golden brown, you know. She told us she had just come from the beauty parlor. "And your father says it's too bad they were closed." My father is. She ignored him. Then she says the operator teased her hair. "And your father says, what with, a chair and a whip?"
father's got quite a will.
Oh, yeah. This time she didn't ignore him. Your father didn't mind, though. He was going to have those five front teeth pulled anyway.
Are you sure this came from your mother?
She might be out around the cider jug again, you know? Well, son, I must close now and go help your father. He's in the hospital again. He had a slight accident the other day. He was milking a... I shouldn't laugh at poor Papa.
I know.
He was milking our old cow on the side of a hill and his foot slipped. And he fell 234 feet down the hill. He wasn't hurt, though, because he hung on. And now we have the only cow in Mount Ida we can keep in the barn and milk in the kitchen. He says you ought to hear...
Where does it say that?
This is right. She says you ought to hear her holler when the tractor goes by the barn. Love, Mama.
Mama's a wild lady.
She's pretty much. And she also... She always sends me my hometown newspaper, too, you know.
Oh, yeah, the Mount Ida one.
Mount Ida Legend. And,
what does that mean, Fuzz Nabb's aging Romeo?
Oh, that's probably it. Oh, Grandpa Snyder, aged 104, local tree surgeon and part-time barfly, was seized by Sheriff Lyle Hose last night.
Lyle Hose?
He's our sheriff.
That's a funny
show.
Oh,
we had to run him, you know. Grandpa was thrown in jail. The charge against him, contriving to break up the romance between the widow Moots, age 101, and Grandpa Fitchley, age 107. After an all-night grilling at the Mount Ida County Jail, Grandpa Snyder admitted, number one, he had hidden under the widow's porch swing while she entertained her boyfriend and had barked like a dog. Number two, he had willfully written on fences and public buildings the words, Grandpa Finchley is an old man. Number three, he had upon four occasions set Grandpa Finchley's beard on fire. Trial will be held as soon as Grandpa Snyder's lawyer, Gomar Cool, is released from the state penitentiary. He has been serving a term of time for dyeing sparrows yellow and selling them for canary. Yeah. Oh, here's a business opportunity. You like business opportunities?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Grandpa Ogg would like to make the acquaintance of a man with $1 million to act as partner in Grandpa's newly proposed $1 million restaurant. No deadbeats need apply. Anyone interested can find Grandpa in the third rocker on the side porch of the Weary Traveler Hotel, next to customer number four. Well, that's Spanish. Local boy seeks stardom. That sounds...
Well, that's always interesting.
78 people lined Highway 101 to bid Charlie Weaver... That's me! Bid Charlie Weaver good luck on his trip to Hollywood to appear on television with a well-known famous singer, Andy Wilson.
Where does it... Where does it say Wilson? That's a typographical song.
I don't know. Mr. Weaver will sing a number of songs, play several musical instruments, and do his hilarious imitation of the Swede catching the hen.
Did you write this?
No, it's in the paper. Mr. Wilson will sing Moon River. Again. That's the Mount Ida.
Well,
Oh, say, Mama wanted me to be sure and see if you wouldn't like to sing one of my songs.
I didn't even know you were a songwriter.
Oh, yes, around Mount Ida. I'm known as a tunesmith.
Tunesmith?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Now, there's one song I wrote, Andy, that's just you. Just you.
Sounds like a nice title.
No, it ain't the title. It's for you. I mean, it's they're draining Snyder Swamp in the morning. Here's your copy. And, get out here. Some plumber's been fooling with this. And I'll accompany you. Okay, where's Jack? Jack, let her rip. You sing that and I'll wing it on this. Huh?
All right.
Hey, you want an introduction?
Please.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Andy Williams.
They're going to put a highway through. They're tearing out the creeping musman.
Sure, you and Albert belong to the same union.
I'm more dehydrated than he is.
No longer will the swamp reflect its blue. They're tearing down the old green pavilion. Where Maud ID used to dance and rum.
You better sing this.
I knew it was in there.
They're draining Snyder Swamp in the morning. Snyder's Swamp.
Charlie Weaver, ladies and gentlemen. Charlie, come back and see us again.
I'll wash up with my money.
All through the night, I delight in your love. All through the night, you're so close to me. All through the night, from a height far above, you when dawn comes to waken me, you're never there at all. I know you've forsaken me till the shadows fall. And then once again I can dream I've the right to be close to you all through the night. Other than once again I can dream of the light to be close.
Thank you very much. Don't go away now. We'll be right back with more of Judy Garland.
Why don't we do this more often?
Like what?
Just what we're doing tonight.
Yeah, that'd be fun, then.
Gee, but it's great to get together like this, to have a chance to sit and reminisce.
Well, that's all right, but Andy, what have we got to reminisce about?
Well, don't tell me you've forgotten already. I mean, we worked together in a picture at MGM, the Harvey Girls.
The Harvey Girls?
Well, sure. You remember you sang the Atchison, Topeka, and the Santa Fe?
Yes.
Well, you must remember I sang that number with you.
Were you in it?
You must remember us. I mean, just sing the song and I'll show you where I came in on my part.
Do you hear that whistle? That'll sound that way on the Atchison, Topeka, and the Santa Fe. Are you sure you were in this number?
Oh, yeah. Just keep going. I'll show you where I came in.
See the old smoke rising round the bend. I reckon that you know she's gonna meet a friend. Folks around these parts get the time of day from the Atchison, Topeka, and the Santa Fe.
I love that song.
Are you positive you were in this picture, Andy? Are you sure the accent is?
Just keep going.
Right. Here she comes.
Well, I wasn't really on the screen, but I was singing in the chorus behind her.
I see.
Well, I was just a kid then.
Well, I wasn't exactly Walter Brennan.
Let's do the rest.
All right.
Then you pull that throttle whistle blow. A huffin' and a puffin' and away she goes.
On the Atchison, Topeka. On the Atchison, Topeka. On the Atchison, Topeka. On the Atchison, Topeka. And it's time.
You don't remember, huh? You know, Judy, I think I've seen every one of your pictures. I've got probably every one of your albums. And there's one song that is really very much associated with you. Everybody associates it with you. You know the one I mean.
Oh, I think so. It has something to do with rainbows, doesn't it?
Yeah. Could I sing a little of it?
Of course, please.
Good.
I'm always chasing rainbows, watching clouds drifting on.
That's very pretty.
I know it's not the one.
That isn't the one.
Why don't you do the one?
Do you want me to?
The right one. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Somewhere. In a lullaby, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I?
Now, come on.
you croon, croon a tune from the heart of Dixie. Just hang my cradle, mammy mine, right on that Mason Dixon line, and swing it from Virginia to Tennessee with all the love that's been there. Weep no more, my lady, sing that song again for me.
I'll never forget a movie you made, and in the movie you sang You Made Me Love You. But before you sang the song, you read a letter, or recited a letter that you had written to Clark Gable. Oh, I love that.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, it must have had appeal, because I suppose everybody at some time in their lives has written a letter to their favorite star.
Oh, I know, I did.
You did?
I was really brokenhearted when she got married.
Well, who was she?
Phyllis Diller. You don't think my wife would let me write to Sophia Loren? Why don't you do that number? And if I do say so myself, I do a pretty fair imitation of Clark Gable myself.
Do you really?
Yeah, I do.
Well, try it, yeah. You made me love. I didn't want to do it. You made me love you. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it.
Of course I do it, baby. I do it all along.
Sometimes you made me glad, but there were times, dear, you made me feel so bad.
I never loved you, Scarlet, baby. I mean, I loved you, Scarlet. Let's keep it down here, folks. Scarlet, you're the only baby I ever loved.
Shall we go on?
Yes, please, yes.
You made me sigh, 'cause I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. I think you're grand. That's true. Yes, I do. Indeed, I do. You know I do.
Of course, baby, I do it all along. I knew it was you, Scarlett, from the very beginning.
That is the rottenest imitation. That's the rottenest imitation.
You're right.
Of course, I've never heard.
know you got the brand of kisses that I die for. My light brown derby and my bright green tie, I was quite the handsomest of men. I started to yen, so I counted to ten, then I counted to ten again.
Clang, 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 went the trolley. Ding, 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 went the bell. Zing, 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 went my heartstring.
From the moment I saw him, I fell.
Chug, 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 went the motor. Bump, 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 went the brain. Bump, 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 went my heartstring.
When she smiled, I could feel the car shake.
He tipped his hat.
He tipped his hat.
And took a seat.
And took a seat.
He said he hoped he hadn't stepped upon my feet.
I asked her name, then lost my breath. She looked so lovely that it scared me half to death.
Buzz, buzz, buzz,
went the buzzer.
Womp, womp, womp,
went the wheel.
Stop, 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 went my heartstring. As we started to go, then I started to know how it feels when the universe reels.
To do this
more often.
Call me anytime, Andy.
Don't you agree that I'm right?
I do. I really do.
We made each other laugh.
We made each other cry.
And sing. You can never, ever overdo a good thing. So,
why don't we do this?
Just
what we're doing. I love what we're doing.
We'll do it again. Good night, Judy.
Good night, Bob. Good night.
star in some pawnbroker's shop and see what he might pay for second-hand hearts today. Such worthless things. What scale could measure them? What other fool could be fool like me and treasure them?
See you next week.
The Andy Williams Show has been brought to you by Kraft. Kraft for good food and good food ideas. Pre-recorded.